When referring to an engine noise, we need to know, when does it occur? Does it occur all the time? Is that ticking present while the engine is idling? Does it occur only when the engine is set into motion or clutch engagement? Or is it under load? If it's only under load, you want to check integrity of the gaskets. If the integrity is okay, then you want to go and check the oil. If the oil is thin, then it doesn't have the lubricating ability, it doesn't have the extreme pressure ability to cushion that rotating part on the crankshaft. So the connecting rod will actually move on that journal up and down because the oil is too thin, it can't cushion that blow. If you change the oil, it restores that cushion and the noise goes away, you've resolved the issue. If the noise does not go away, then the condition of being thin or diluted has gone into a progressive damage state. So then you would need to refer to the lower end and do a heavier inspection. If the gaskets have failed or they're not good, you replace the gaskets and that should resolve the knocking noise under load. If the mount is broken, it's a simple fix. Just replace the mount. You're going to want to recheck it and you should have satisfied the repair with the replacement. There should not be any noise. Of course, when you have the hood open, you're not going to see necessarily the engine hit the hood, but you might see it hit the pipe or the air cleaner. And when you do the recheck, there should be no noise or no visible extreme movement of the engine, and it'll be resolved. If the engine does not lift, that is not the only source of a noise during clutch engagement. If you hear a chirping, clicking, sometimes knocking, what can happen is this. A gasket, say for instance, between the exhaust manifold and the cylinder head may have failed, blown out. An exhaust gas under that high pressure of combustion or exhaust will actually come through that failed gasket and make a noise. It can really be shrill or it can be a lower noise that is emitted from that leak. The same thing is true of a head gasket. You can hear a head gasket chirp when it is blown. When the combustion or exhaust stroke comes about, it'll actually whistle or make a noise as it's exiting where it should be contained. You want to check the belt and see that if it's loose, and you're going to make an adjustment and recheck to see if the noise is present or if it has gone away. When you make an adjustment, you want to restart the engine if the belt were loose, let's say, and see if the noise is gone or if it's still there. If the noise is gone, you've resolved the problem. If the noise is still present, then is when you want to check the condition to make sure that there aren't any pieces missing or that it's cracked. If there are cracks in and pieces missing, then you want to replace the belt or belts and then restart it and see if the noise goes away. If it does, then you've resolved the source of the noise. If the noise is still there, then most likely the belt was not the problem. So then the next thing you want to check into is the valve train. So the flow chart for the ticking noise on these two components that we just went over, when we go into the valve train, we're going to check and see if it's loose or out of spec. You'll have to check with manufacturers for those specifications. If it is loose, you'll need to adjust and see, then recheck to see if the noise is there. If the noise has gone away, the issue is resolved. If the noise is still present, then you want to check the valve train components. Those components we mentioned earlier, they are camshaft, cam follower, push rod, rocker arm, crosshead, valves, valve springs, and valve retainers. If those components are in a failed state, then you'll want to replace, make adjustments, and it should, if the noise came from the valve train, should be corrected. If the noise is still present, then you want to go on to the injector train.
Give us a shout, 844-447-1453, or you can go on our website and use the online quoting tool. We'd be glad to give you a quote at www.highwayandheavyparts.com. From diagnosis through delivery, we're Highway and Heavy Parts.